Again, I welcome you all. I've never been to Missions of Love. And you see the screen here? So if you feel like drifting off, you can read there. There's a message there too. So no matter what happens, we're going to get the message of God to you. Now, you just heard the word today. No, we're not going to talk about money. In the Bible, it's talking about money that someone had gotten for God. But we're going to look a little deeper. We're going to look into lying to God. You see, there's plenty of things that go on. Let me explain this a little further here. One day, as a man was walking down the street, he just kneeled over with a massive heart attack and died. Another incident was a woman who was keeping the books for her church. While she was tending her roses, she just kneeled over with a heart attack. Later, it was discovered that she'd been putting entries into the church books about donations that were given by her that were not given. I'm not saying God killed these people. What I am saying is someone lied to God. You see, today, there's a lot of people lying to God every single day. How many times do you go and say, I will pray for somebody, and you don't pray for them? We'll pray for you. Then next Sunday comes, and you really never prayed for them. What did you just do? You just lied to God. Now, if you were a parent, and your child said, I'm going to wash the dishes, and then that night came and the dishes were sitting in the sink dirty, you're not going to tell a child, you know, you forgot. You're going to say, you lied to me. You said you were going to do the dishes and you didn't do the dishes. And here's the consequence. Well, God is the same way. Bishop, Pastor Woods has a church he's building. It's got the foundation laid to it. How many people have said they're going to help grow that church in words? How many people said when the foundation was just laid in, the preachers preaching and the choir singing, the ring, I'm going to do everything. And when they leave the church, you're like, man, I got bills to pay. Oh, imagine if you would. I know Pastor Woods would not schedule that celebration on Super Bowl night. Why? There will be so many people lying to God. I'm going to go to church, and guess what? Their head is down in church listening to the game. Or they're at home listening to the game, lying to God. I worship God, but I don't have time for God. I love God, but I don't have time. You see, we put God in our back pocket. We wear faith like jewelry. How many times you see a cross worn on someone's chest? It doesn't mean anything until you have Jesus in your heart. You're lying to God. Now, in that instance where I said someone died, instantly you don't know if they're being punished for something they did. But it should serve as a warning, because God, as in Acts 5, if he gets mad enough, he will take care of business right then, right now. You don't know how many people have died in this world because God said enough is enough, and he just took them out. I have seen somebody here in St. Cloud worship Santeria. That's voodoo for the Spanish. It's actually originated in Cuba. I'm a nurse, and he was sitting or laying there in the emergency room. His kidneys had failed, his pancreas had failed, and his liver had failed. He had a 2.5 blood alcohol alcohol in his blood, and he was high on crack cocaine. The doctor said he was going to die. They put him on morphine, a morphine IV drip. His face was yellow, his eyes were yellow. I went in there and saw him. Do you know what he did? I didn't have time to say, well, brother, it's going to be okay. Don't worry. The man is dying. As a nurse, I'm watching him die. I work for hospice, and I can tell you when someone's about to die. You know it. I'm sure, Pastor Woods, you've been in the business. You know when someone, they don't have to tell you, he's going to die. You just know. So I'm looking at this man, and I say to him, what are you going to do? I don't know where it came from. I just said, what are you going to do when you die? Where are you going to go? And he didn't say a word. I said, let me tell you right now. And I had his Bible with me. I said, you got a choice to make right now. You either can decide if you're going to go to hell or you're going to go to heaven. You can't bargain with God. You can't say, I'll believe in you if you do this. Mm-hmm. You see, Jesus already did something. God did his part. We didn't do our part. It was not time for that man to lie. Lying was already out of question because he only had a few hours. And yes, I can bring him to this church and you can meet him. Amen. So, he gave his life to Christ. His prayer was not one of these things you see on TV that go, the sinner's prayer that goes on like for 4 hours, people jumping up. Do you know what he said? God, forgive me. I'm a sinner. He said, Jesus, I ask you into my life. He never once said, heal me. He said, I ask you to come into my life. I have been wrong. Now, his whole, you got to realize, this man had been in Santeria. He was like 30-some years old his whole life. His mother is still into that. She's a leader in whatever they do. I forgot the titles of what the women have. But she's pretty high up. They even went to Cuba. Did you know that night, his organs turned on? Every one of them. He didn't go through drug withdrawal at all. The alcohol actually disappeared from his blood. They were doing tests. He was working perfectly. No withdrawal, nothing. They kept him in the hospital for a week because they said something's not right, that something's working right. And it was Jesus that came in. Because you see, he did not lie to God. He was honest. He goes, I am a sinner. I am truly sorry. Please forgive me. I will accept anything you give me, God, but I am giving myself to you. Yes, you can have a deathbed confession. I've witnessed it. He is now walking around. He walked out of the hospital not craving one drug. And I'm sure Pastor Woods has seen this, and maybe some of you all have seen withdrawals. When someone hasn't, when they've been on drugs, they're on the ground doing their thing. He was just like you and me. The only difference was he was hungry. I'm serious. That's what he said. He said, I'm hungry. And the doctors wanted to give him IV food. He said, no. I want real food. You see, when you don't lie to God, he'll do things. Amen. But when you lie to him, he's not going to do anything. Now you look at the story that we just heard in Acts. They lied outright to God. Now, I'm just going to use Pastor Woods as an example because he's here. How many people have outrightly lied to God that they're going to help his church? You see, they're trying to build a building. He doesn't need to hear lips flapping. He needs to share the gospel. They are working hard. There's some people working day and night, but there's also somebody in there that has told God, I'm going to do everything for St. Luke Missionary Baptist Church, and they haven't done anything. You know what? As they said, they haven't lied to man. They didn't lie to Pastor Woods, the congregation, the choir. They lied to God himself. Now, I'm not trying to solve all the problems, but we need to look at this. We need to look at ourselves. Have we been lying to God? Most common lie, like I mentioned before, is praying for somebody. And a lot of new ministers will pray for everybody. You'll hear them. I'll pray for you. I'll pray for you. I'll pray for you. And you see him at Burger King. Now, God knows he didn't pray for all of them. Now, there's a lot to do. Don't get me wrong. The next time you say that you'll pray for somebody, do it then. Do it now. Stop what you're doing and pray for them in earnest. Get the Holy Spirit into your system and be the intercessory between God. You hold God's hand in this hand, and you hold their hand in this hand, and you make that bridge, and you start praying for them. Amen. Next time you go by a church, I don't care if it's a Presbyterian church, or Baptist church or Church of God like we are, if you know they're in trouble, you've got a couple of minutes. Get down there and touch that building and start praying for them that their congregation will grow. It doesn't matter what denomination you are. It doesn't matter how you look like when you go to church. It matters what your heart looks like. Stop lying to God that you're going to do all these things. Now let's get to the crux of the situation. Missionaries doing work for God. I'm going to go out. I can sing. I'm going to sing for God. No, you'll see them. There's some awesome singers out there. Really awesome. They started in church and they left church. But I bet you when they were in church, a lot of them said, man, I always sing to God. I love God. And as soon as someone slaps some money in front of them, they're out of church. I'm being honest. Musicians too. Now that's another thing. Missions of love, I love getting musicians that aren't in the church. And I want to bring them into the church. I'm not worried about somebody who's sanctified and blessed. And I want to get somebody who's got a gift that God gave them and show them how to use it for God. Amen. You see, when you do that, they're going to stay in the church. They're not in the business of mine because guess what? They're already out in the world. You can be out in the world without being in the world. It's like being in a boat. You can be in the water, but you're not in the water. You're in the boat. But you play around with that boat, it will sink. I guarantee you play with some matches and a drill, and you're about 10 miles out in the ocean, you're going to have a problem real quick. Same thing with God. You start playing with fire. You start going to church, and you're singing church music, and you're praising God, and you go outside and you degrade God. That's the wrong answer. I'm not telling you not to sing. In fact, right now I'm looking for a rapper. I want someone to sing rap with one of our songs. Or some people say MCing. I want someone to sing half. You can do it with God. Just give God the glory. You can listen to R&B. You can listen to blues. Look at the song that we just sang. A rock and roll song. It gave Jesus the glory. We took it away from the world and gave it back to God. All these songs you sing out in the world, you can do that. You know, the devil's got a song. Take it from him. Slap it in his face and say, I'm taking that back to God. Change the words. Change the beat. Change your meaning and just say, God, this is yours. I want to share your glory. Amen. How many songs today have you seen they call crossovers? You know, you're listening to the dial and you're like, man. And I'm talking about secular people. You're like, man, that's not a Christian song. I said, dude, that is. I'm sorry. That song, this is the stuff she sings. Mm-hmm. You know, I had somebody actually here say, that's not a Christian song. I said, man. You're in the wrong place. It is a Christian song. It's just the secular people don't know that God has never left the sea. Uh-huh. That's not lying to God. I may be a musician. I'm not. I want to be. I'm not even going to the singing routine. But you know what? If I were a musician, I can play harmonica. I admit that.
Amen.
And I'll tell you the truth. I took that from the devil. How did I take it from the devil? The man who taught me how to play harmonica worshiped the devil. He had his little ring on there. In fact, he told me when I was in the military, he goes, I have to tell you, I worship the devil. We don't say prayers here. But God was speaking to me. So you know, we always opened up because I played the band with him, knocking on heaven's door. That's how we started. But what I'm trying to say is, we took that harmonica playing and I gave it to God. And I play music for God, with God, and to God. Now the devil's probably mad because he thought I was going to do something else with his thing that he had one of his people teach me. But you know, I pray for Sergeant Stickley. That's that man. Sergeant Stickley was going blind. Man, he could play. But he didn't realize the devil didn't give him nothing. God gave it to him. He was too busy lying to himself, saying the devil did it, instead of accepting the truth and God gave it. We got to stop lying in the church. How many times that We said we accepted Christ and we really haven't accepted him.